Renato, hoe gaat het ermee? Hoe is het om deze week in Marbella te zijn met Feyenoord?
Yeah, good. We feel good. It's been a couple of days easy. Yesterday was really hard. So yeah, it's really nice to be back on business. I think it's the most important thing to be a unit again after a tough year. I think we have to start this second part of the season really, really good against tough rival, so we hope everything goes well. We just have to be focused and finish good the training camp and then go back to all and really fit.
Je hebt 2 weken vrij gehad na de kerst. Wat heb je gedaan in die periode?
Nah, not much. It was really easy and there were a lot of people in Peru that wants to take picture and wants to be with me, but yeah, we got family time. I got a lot of things to do, so it was quite in my vacation.
Je bent natuurlijk ook als middenvelder ooit naar Feyenoord gekomen, yes. 2 jaar geleden. De laatste maanden zien we je eigenlijk als centrale verdediger. Hoe is dat ineens?
Yeah, it's not new for me. I play also in Twente and in the national team as a central defender. Not on a high level like now, but yeah, like I say, I have to get used to it, and that was my opportunity, and I think I took it. I knew I had to be sharp and ready for the opportunity. I knew that a lot of guys have a lot of quality. Yeah, we were unlucky that some guys got injured. And I didn't want it to be this way, but actually it came. And yeah, I think, like I say, always I had to be patient and wait for this chance.
Was it moeilijk om geduldig te zijn?
It was difficult. It was difficult because it was I spent like 1.5 years, almost two, to be part of the first 11. It couldn't happen, but I was all, like I say, I was always ready to be on a team and help everybody. So I always did.
Toen kwam die wedstrijd tegen Napoli dat Jan Arie net daarvoor geblesseerd raakte.
Yeah.
Toen moest jij er ineens.
Yeah, I hear it 2 minutes before we had to go in. So, yeah, but this is football. You never know when it's coming, and yeah, it was not the best experience. But I think. As a team, we develop ourselves, and actually at the last weeks of the first half, I think we did really good. And, we improved a lot from the first games, and we hope we keep this way.
Hebben jullie in de eerste seizoen zelf iets te veel punten eigenlijk thuis verloren in de Kuip? Hoe kijk je daarop terug?
Ja, we have to see now this part of this season. Of course we lose a lot of points. We drop many points on drawing and everything, but yeah, we just have to be focused now on not dropping more points and take all the points at home and as much as possible away. So we just have to be focused on it.
Martin van Geel zei, er zijn eigenlijk 2 doelen voor het tweede seizoen zelf. Dat is jagen op de clubs die boven ons staan en de beker winnen.
Yeah.
Zie je dat ook zo?
Ja, yeah, of course, as a club, as a player, you want to win as much as you can. Of course, we're more close than the beker, than the championship, of course. But we will keep going. We will keep giving everything and I hope it goes well.
De start is wel lastig. Ajax uit, Utrecht uit en dan ook nog PSV in de beker. Hoe kijk je naar de eerste weken van de tweede seizoen?
Ja, yeah, it's gonna be difficult. It's gonna be a tough weeks, but we had it before and it's nothing new. We just have to keep the level up and I think everything is gonna be okay. And if we keep the level as the first 20-30 minutes of each game that we had, I think everything is going to be really, really good.
Jou vanochtend bij de training hebben we weer een beetje gevolgd met de camera. Dan zien we je de hele tijd lachen en dollen met iedereen. Is dat de rol die je graag hebt?
Ja, yeah, this is me. This is my personality. This is what I always do. I like to be fun, to have fun on the training. Of course, when the real training starts, then I'm serious. But this is me. This is how I am. So.
Is dit ook dat je dat nu echt durft te laten zien, omdat je goed in je vel zit en speelt?
Nah, we know it's like this. It's not that I'm playing. Of course, it has sometimes like a really good feeling that you're playing and you give more than you have. So, so also can happen. But I'm always like that, and I'm trying to everybody laugh and have a nice feeling in the training. So, yeah.
Met wie kan je het meest lachen?
Yeah, I cannot be serious with Jens. With Jens, it's always something happen, and yeah, you look at Jens, and he's always not laughing out loud, but yeah, you look at him, and you know he's making a joke or something. So yeah, it's really difficult to handle it.
We zien jullie veel lachen, maar aan de andere kant wordt er ook gewoon keihard gewerkt. Dan moesten jullie gisteren best veel lopen en zo. Is dat hoe het hoort te gaan, dat plezier en prestatie?
Yeah, of course. Like I say, when the training starts, you have to change your mentality and be on winning mentality and fight for the position. Also, is healthy fight, but yeah, you're still fighting for your. For your own position, so yeah, I think we know the difference really well. So yeah, I think this is really good.
Do you alles om te winnen, ook op een training?
Yeah, of course. I think this is also South American mentality. So yeah, I don't like to lose even in training. So I always get mad when we're losing, we're down. So yeah, it's okay. So I think it's really good.
Maar vandaag zat je in the winning team.
Yeah, we were on the winning team. Yeah, I'm kind of used to it, but yeah, it's okay. It's all about the love and the joy that we have to train to play football. So it's okay.
Vol vertrouwen richting het tweede seizoen zo?
Yeah, of course, 100%. Always looking forward and try to be on the top.